Good for her.
Very good. All right, thank you, gentlemen. 22 minutes in front of the hour on the Wall Street Journal this weekend. Toyota's recall problems, as you know, are leading to some discounts at dealer lots, and this could spread to rival car companies like, say, Honda or Ford or Chevy. It might soon be a very good time to buy a car. That said, some things to keep in mind as you head into the showroom. Guidance now from Mark Ragsdale, former car dealer, who's out with a new book. It's called Car Wreck, in which he says the car buying process does not have to be so demoralizing. Thank you very much. Mark, why do you like certain websites rather than others, like autotrader.com and cars.com?
I like them because online used car shopping is getting very, very competitive. And, you know, it's a virtual marketplace out there versus going from lot to lot to lot to see what each dealer wants to sell you their used car for example. When you're trading in a used car, you need to have some relevant basis as to what the dealers are going to give you. It's more difficult to look out of a book and come up with a fair assessment of what your car is worth. Autotrader.com and Cars.com show you what all the dealers are selling your car for currently. So it gives you a nice, rounded basis with a lot of data to kind of come up with an average of what you should be receiving.
Generally speaking, when it comes to leasing versus buying, Mark, do you find that the consumer does better when doing one or the other financially? Is the consumer in a better position financially when it comes to buying versus leasing?
Gordon, I have some very strong feelings on this, and unfortunately they disagree with the folks at Consumer Reports and Dave Ramsey, but I love leasing, and let me tell you why. It puts a floor on what your car is going to depreciate to, meaning when I buy a car, even if I pay cash, I am a slave to market forces. If Ralph Nader gets out and says this vehicle is unsafe at any speed, or in modern terms, what's going on with Toyota right now, there's an awful lot of liability in owning a car. Now, if you owe money on that car while it's dropping like a rock in a sock on the marketplace, that just aggravates your upside-down position. If you look at leasing, however, there you need to pick a short-term lease. I advocate 36, 42, 48 months at the most. And you don't really care what that car is worth at trade-in time. You have the ability to drop off the keys.
Is it worth it for the consumer who might see some sort of discount on leasing or recall to do it?
Absolutely.
Is it a danger, too, is my question.
Well, from a safety perspective?
Yeah.
Well, I think they're trying to ferret that out now. They're trying to figure out, you know, do they really have a grip on what the cause of these conditions are? So I think that's being thoroughly vetted. But when you lease one of the cars, even if all this stuff isn't sorted out and you find out that the car is going to depreciate massively, you're off the hook. You don't care.
It's Mark Ragsdale, again, former car dealer. His book, his new one, is called Car Wreck. 19 minutes in front of the hour on the Wall Street Journal this weekend. Coming up next, why you're not as unpredictable as you think.